here is the parking for Yellow Birch Ravine. It's not great parking, but there's not usually a lot of people here. So we just kind of parked on the side of the road there. Splish splash.
Do you want to follow the rocks and stuff?
Yeah, we can. It's more overgrown this way. Oh gosh. Watson, go slow, buddy. Oh, it feels nice. Okay, there is, if you're following the creek down, you have to climb up this, where this, I don't know, like 3 or 4 tree trunks are down, which was kind of difficult to do with the dogs. Ringo hopped right up it. Then Watson was scared and he fell. Really, it's hard to get lost. You can just follow the creek all the way down. There are also paths and trails, but they're kind of overgrown. Ringo, you're such a show off. A lot of climbing involved.
Probably easiest right there, buddy.
Yeah, that's the smallest route, I would say. Come on, Ringo, watch Ringo do it.
See?
Oh. There you go, buddy. He did it. Oh, this is really muddy. Oh, shit. I guess stay to the left. This is really, really muddy.
Okay. Come on, Mark.
Okay. Quite a few climbing obstacles if you go down the creek. Starting to open up more now. You can hear the waterfall. That is a big boulder. There are multiple waterfalls. This is the smaller one. Or no, is this the big one? Okay, no, I think this is the big one. It's all dried up.
Different.
Yeah. Yeah, see, yeah, because this isn't supposed to dip down like this. Okay, we went to the wrong waterfall. All right, we're getting close. You'll see this on your left. Kind of opens up. Starts to get cooler. Creek's down there. You kind of follow the creek down. Here, I got Ringo.
Come on, Watson. Go, Watson. Go, Watson. Come on. Go.
Watson's learning. He hasn't been on a whole lot of hikes before. You Ringo's an expert.
You got it.
So we just crossed the stream. Path's taking us up back by these rocks to the left, and you should be about there at this point. We have never went here when everything was in full bloom, so we got kind of confused about the trail, because whenever everything's dead, I mean, it's hard to see where the trail is, so we would usually just kind of zigzag through and follow the creek down. So we did get lost once, and after some debate, we went back, came back again, and found the right way. So. There we go, and it spits you out right here. By the waterfall. Look, he's so happy. Very
One waterfall that's with some space between, you know? If you have fun, I'll look at it. I'm glad we just gave him a bath. You found a space.
Okay, so as you're walking straight, you'll want to go this way, up the hill, up that little path right there. As you're headed towards the waterfall, there's where the path continues. Okay, this is where we got lost at the first time and confused. Like I said, we've always been here whenever it wasn't so bushy, so it looks way different. We never really followed a trail. If you follow the trail, it's pretty easy to moderate. It's a lot harder if you go down the creek, but this is where we went wrong. Here's if you follow the trail all the way straight from the parking lot, it'll lead you out to the creek right here, the big creek. And we went straight that way. There's a little trail over there, but you don't want to go that way. That's where it dead ends into the little waterfall. If you want to see the little waterfall, go that way, but the big waterfall, you'll want to go this way to the right. And then it veers over and goes left and then back up that hill. So go to the right once you hit the creek, not the left. Go to the right. Nope for president. All right. Okay, also, so here's the parking. Also, on the right-hand side here, there's a little trail. We've never been down that way before, but apparently there's an arch, just a big, like, stone arch or something. We're gonna do that next time, but from what I've read, it's not very far from the road here. Beautiful day.